Hello again, everyone out there. Creamy goodness back for part 6 of my Let's Play Rimworld. This episode, we're gonna see my bedrooms getting finished off. Hopefully, we'll get to see some bigger raids, bigger than one person at least. I'm sure we will. And pretty much, we're just gonna be building up our colony, probably getting some more researching done, maybe start collecting metal for my spaceship. So we'll get this started. Go ahead and get the other bedrooms placed here. And the doors. Probably get the rest of my hallway built here too. I don't want them slowly moving here. Also, I think I might designate one of my colonists purposely just for hauling right now, because there's a lot of rocks in my hallways. I don't like rocky hallways. Get all these suckers designated to be hauled here. Like, put them right out by my stone crafter there, so you can get them done nice and quickly, or get them crafted into stone blocks. Alright, get one of our colonists here. Who's the most useless? Let's see here. It's probably gonna be jellyfish right now. Sorry, jellyfish. Oh, right, forgot to. Maybe once he's done with that rock. No, he's still mining. Oh, he's trapped. That's why. Alright, well, all he has to do is just mine this rock, and he can get out. Or, I'm sorry, he has to mine this rock, and then someone else will mine the other rock. Get him right out of there. Oops, let's get gross on that. Colin is stuck! Someone help him, he's starving. There we go. Alright. I think I'll actually probably just dig out the rest of this before I seal up this room. I think I'll just get jellyfish or bed here in one of my unfinished rooms. I got a lot of stone laying around, I'll probably just make it out of stone now. Alright, now jellyfish has a real bed. Ever build this guy's stone wall here? There you go. Alright, sell this off too. And probably get some lighting in here. Apparently I did not do power all the way over here, but that's fine. I'm just gonna go ahead and go the cheap way here. It does not bother me too much. Alright. Then we'll get some lights in there. Alright, I guess we'll get some more researching started. Might as well, that ship's gonna take us quite a while. Pretty sure my cook should be able to cook better meals now. Check him out here. Yep, can start making fine meals. Awesome. Give our colony a nice needed mood lit bonus. Go ahead and do go. Alright. I think I'm gonna go ahead and suspend a simple meal too. Oh, I forgot to do something. I'm gonna pause the video real quick here. Okay, so what I did was I made a stockpile next to my cook stove, and I made it have critical priority and only vegetarian. I do this because my butcher table gets a good supply of meat usually. Oh, mechanoids again. Uh-oh, looks like we got something much more deadly this time. So he has a heavy charge blaster, which is really nasty. Oh, and there's a Scyther coming too. So we'll go ahead and get our colonist set up. I'm sure you'll get to see the big guy shooting at us sooner or later. Let's see, where's that Scyther at? They move pretty quickly, as you can see here. It's just mowing across the map here. Alright. I think we're gonna go ahead and get our sniper all over here. I like to put my short range at the front, obviously. Oh no, poor innocent squirrel was killed. He got one of his arms off. Alright, Terrence gunned him down. So, these guys are pretty much just like big tanks. It's gonna take them quite a while to get to my colony. Go ahead and fast forward. They moo like cows also. It's an electronic moo. When will the senseless animal killing end? The poor boom rats. There you go, that's the heavy charge blaster in action. It's a really deadly minigun. As you can see, he's soaking up quite a few bullets here. It's pretty hard to take him down. He's got a good amount of armor, too. Oops. Alright, he's down. Cool. So, that battle went pretty well for a two-person mechanoid raid. Definitely could have lost some more turrets and more colonists. But, as you saw there, he wasn't very accurate with his gun. Really interesting that I've gotten so many mechanoid raiders. I've never had 3 mechanoid raids, one after the other. That's very strange. I've played this game quite a bit too. I definitely have a couple hundred hours into it. Alright, so now we can start researching other ship parts. Might as well go for the most lengthy one first to get your colonist research skill up. Another thing that this fire over here is reminding me of is the game has home regions, and it does not yet designate your farming fields as a home region. And what a home region does essentially shows where your colonists to go to repair and fight fires. So you got a bunch of nice roasted boom rat from the battle. You can go ahead and chop that up. Real quick, I'm going to make a stockpile the same as this stockpile, only with meats. So I'm just going to pause the video. Alright, and that allows my cook to very quickly access all of her needed materials for meals. There's nothing there right now, but you can just tell her to go haul some and she'll restock it. You can't notice it yet, but the finer the meals get, they do take longer. You don't really notice it until the lavish meals. The lavish meals take a good hour or two to make. It's really ridiculously long. Hey there guys, sorry about that random jump in the video. My application crashed, but I did have a close by autosave, so just loaded it right back up. We're on the same day, back to the same hour, just a little bit different pawn placement. So, now that my tailor station is done, I can start making some clothes for my colonists. I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna set cowboy hats to be... This recipe cannot have target account because it has multiple or unpredicted products. Okay. Well, that's interesting. Alright, I guess I'll just make a few cowboy hats, enough for every single person in my colony. And I'm only making one shirt and one pants because, oh, apparently I have two tribals. Okay. I will be making two shirts and two pants. Generally, the tribal wear, it counts as actually a jacket and outside armor, so it would count as, you know, a duster or an armor vest. Those would be the cloth items to be replaced by it, not so much your your shirt. And our crafter should get right on that. I'm pretty sure that tailoring has a higher priority than stone cutting, because it is a bill-specific crafting. Or, I'm sorry, it's not as long-term as stone cutting anyway. They're both bill-specific. Alright, so we'll go ahead and get Batches a shirt. And we'll get Jellyfish a shirt. Now, the shirts and pants, they don't give you a great bonus until you can get some Synth Weave or Devil Strand. Speaking of which, I think I will actually start growing some Devil Strand. Devil Strand is more of an endgame item. It can be used early game as well, but it's... you're just not going to be able to get it that quickly. It takes a very long time to grow. So that's why I'm making an enormous field of it here. So I have a good amount of it to grow with, and you can even sell it if you want to make some good money. So they'll get right on that. Cowboy hats are The one thing that's really nice about the tailoring workbench is the cowboy hats, because they are a little bit rare. Hat items are a little bit difficult to find, so it's nice to just give everyone a hat item so their brains are a bit more protected. You take a bullet to the brain, your colonist is never going to be the same, that's for sure. Combat supplier, cool. Always like to see combat suppliers. We'll get Galena on the comms. Alright, let's see what we have here. Alright, so I think that we're going to go ahead and sell a good amount of our tribal weapons we found, as well as our heart and our kidney. Could always use some more medicine, and we definitely need silver for that. I don't really want to buy any weapons from them. I think I'm just going to go ahead and grab a few medkits. Also, I do believe, if you're looking for profit, I believe that the cowboy hat is worth the most to traders, even though the pants and shirts do take up more material. Another combat supplier. Well, we don't got anything to trade to him. Massive field is coming along nicely. I think I might actually refine my defenses a little bit more here. I do want to be able to shoot on people as soon as they cross around that corner. I think I'm going to mine out this whole mountainside right here. And I think I'm going to actually add an additional sandbag area right here to fight raiders coming from this side. And I'll probably build turrets going up along here. Oh, escape crash pod. Incapable of violent, so he's completely useless when raiders come. He's a great medic, wow. He could be a warden, researcher growing. He's not great. I'm definitely going to pick him up, and if not use him, at least harvest his organs, but I guess I'm going to have to think about taking him in. I generally do not take colonists that are incapable of violence. Unless they're really good, of course. Awesome. Space berries. I hope Gross does not get slain again. I think I'm actually gonna do this the clever way. Go ahead and get that, and then that. Alright, there we go. Now the roof should not collapse on top of him. At least until he's on the outside of it. So we got a lot of stone. We can do a good amount of stuff with stone. What I like to do in my colonists, like I said, I like to play on the outside a lot. I don't generally like to box myself in with mountains. I actually, even though I said I don't like to box myself in, I do like to create a enormous stone wall around myself. Sometimes I'll layer it two stone walls thick if I really want to keep everyone out. I don't really need that here. I did build kind of into a mountain, and I'm already pretty much protected. And as you can see here, the enemies do already pretty much get funneled in. But a good idea to do is to always wall in your geothermal generators. It's never fun when they go out. And you might be thinking, oh, if I wall it in, I'm not going to be able to put the fire out on it. It doesn't matter. If there's a fire on it, it's probably already spread to the inner blocks on it, and your colonists can't reach those. It's already gone for. Look at all the critters just hanging out in my courtyard. Alright, so let's get Gross to start mining all this out. I'm gonna take out the outer parts first and probably inch himself in. I don't want him to mine it all at once and place himself somewhere really stupid when the roof comes down. Alright, we'll get another piece of the ship started here. See right there, the ceiling does come down. So you want to be really smart about who's in the way and when we do it. That's not good, Gross. That's not smart. Go ahead and go on the outside there. There you go. Alright, we'll get him to mine the last two blocks. And we're going to make sure that no one's around or goes in there when we do it. Oh, I guess it's not going down. Cool. Alrighty then, we will start building our nice little sandbag area here. I'm probably going to build it against the rock collection here. The rocks make for a nice deterrent for melee characters trying to run out really fast and just beat the crap out of your colonists. So we'll go ahead and set that here. I think I'm actually going to sell this guy. I might rebuild him nearby. Alright. Alright. So we're gonna go ahead. I'm not actually gonna build all those, I am just placing those for reference currently. Alright, I'm going to build the farthest one away, because that's generally what's going to get the most hits from raiders. And craft smooth stone all along these rooms here. Make it look nice and pretty. Alright. So I think I'm gonna go ahead and finish my hallway design too. Might as well. Get my colonists around faster. Oops. Oh, I don't know if I want to... Actually, this looks like there's some more minerals back there. I think I might. This might actually be worth a stone door to be put in. I might make this my back door mine. I don't know. We'll see. Alright, so it looks like we need more power. These geothermal generators definitely are not endless. My base is getting pretty big and demanding. So, this is when having this enormous horde of stone blocks comes in handy. I think I'm actually going to stone off this little area here between my colony and build in here a bunch of solar panels. I might also mine this out. So I think I'm going to go ahead and get the blueprint started here. Group from Travelers, Trade Ship, Combat Spire. Don't want any of that. Alright. I think I'm going to make a stone door all the way down here, because we do want my colonists to be able to access it, if need be. Good idea is to also make sure you put floors on the outside of your colony, because in battle, that extra movement speed can really make a difference and save colonists' lives if you're quick with it. So you want to make sure you have nice paving and your colonists can get where they need to be very quickly. Oops, that looks ugly. Go ahead and fix that up a bit here. Alright, make stone tile. I personally think it's a little bit silly how the smooth stone is the most elegant looking floor in the game. It doesn't look much better than concrete to me. But I guess that's just the way the game was made. I guess that you could consider that a carryover from Dwarf Fortress, as smooth stone was definitely a big factor in that game. Don't seem to want to be building the stone wall as much as they want the pirates. Arg, let's see what they are. Oh, we got 7 of them here, and they are in not nice gear. I see an M24, I see another M24, LMG, pistol, Molotov cocktails, frag grenades, and more Molotov cocktails. Alrighty, well, that's definitely a good team. This guy's in power armor here. This guy's in Devil Strand. They're definitely gonna be a little hard to take down. And, I guess we're gonna have to try to break their siege, because they're gonna be hanging out there for quite a while. I don't really want them hacking at my colony forever. So, I'm gonna go ahead and gather together my best shooters. Or, I guess I'm gonna gather my only colonists with an M24 anyway. So we'll get Galena on over there. See, her food and rest is all the way at full, so she makes for a perfect raid. I guess you call her raid assault. So we're going to go ahead and fast forward here, get her up within range. So that circle is her range on the M24. And the other people with M24s have the same range. So we're trying to pick them off one by one when they're just out of their range. Alright, take them down, Galena. Oh. We're going to try to take down that turret now, because we are in range of that turret to take a few shots at it. Oh, never mind. Try to see if we can shoot him again. Hey, one shot kill. Torso is done. He must have not had any torso armor. So, what I like to do sometimes, despite wanting to go for the mortar because obviously it's wrecking my colony, I actually like to use the mortar as a lure for the raiders, because the raiders are always trying to go up to the mortars and fire at your colony. If you can actually pick off the guy firing the mortar, then they're going to have no choice but to go up to it and use it if they actually want to keep on firing. And this guy is going to fire on my colonist, so I think I'm going to back up a little bit here. Get out of his range. Alright. Let's see here. What is he doing? Okay, he's walking away. Let's go ahead and try to get a little bit closer here to that mortar. Just a little bit closer. Okay, there we go. Where's this guy going? Oh, he's hauling nearby metal. Hey, we got one of them, and one of the raiders. Galena's taking some free shots here at him. See if he can't nail one of them. Oh! She did hit him, but it just dinked off the armor. He had enough armor to completely repel the shot. However, it freaked him out enough for him to be like, I'm out of here, man. I ain't taking another bullet. We got another one running away. See, broken, fleeing in panic. Oh, we shot his left foot off just now. He's bleeding through his leg, and he's not running away very quickly. All right. So, we ended up killing enough of them that now they're angry at us and coming to assault the colony. So we're going to get Galena out of there as fast as she can. Hopefully she doesn't take too many gunshots. Looks like she's quick enough. We're going to go ahead and just let our turrets finish off the last two guys here. More waiting for him. I think I'm going to check out this guy. Oh, he's incapable of skilled labor. All right, well, at least you got organs. That works for me. Go ahead and get jellyfish behind the sandbags here. He doesn't know what's coming for him. Batches. His right arm. Nice shot. He's definitely very poor at shooting now that his right arm shot off. You can see almost nothing is hitting. As you would think, you would need two arms to shoot a heavy machine gun, or a light machine gun, I guess it's called. Alrighty, so we got him down. Finally. Looks like his friend is running away too there. Cool. And that's how you take care of a siege with ease. Alright guys, well that's going to wrap up my part 6. I hope you enjoyed it. Please thumbs up the video, subscribe, or comment below. Keep an eye out for my next part. And thanks for watching. I will see you guys next time.